Hello, in this video I introduce how to track and calculate the number of working days for each employee in Microsoft Excel. You use this spreadsheet every month of the year. Or you can reuse them in subsequent years. First, I created a sheet to track the number of working days of employees. This is January 2024. I put the sample file in the description. First, I create a list of days of the month. I use a function to determine the first day of January 2024. Then I created a list of other days in January. January of all years has 31 days. The default format was too long, so I changed the format. I only use 2 characters to identify days in a month. This will look neater and more beautiful. Based on the days of the month, I use the function to determine the days of the week. I abbreviate the days of the week with the first 3 letters. I created an abbreviated list of days of the week. I then determine the day of the week based on the day of the month of a given year. Why use a function for this instead of entering it manually? The purpose of this is for reuse in the future. And I just duplicate this sheet for the next months of the year in the next step. Each employee can work a full day or a half day, so I created a drop-down list as follows. Employees work all day or only work in the morning or only work in the afternoon. When employees only work in the morning or only work in the afternoon, they will be counted as working half a day. I format the colors differently when employees work half a day. Different color formats show you the difference and make your spreadsheet more interesting. I have 3 different formats for each type of workday. After you have tracked each employee's workdays, you should count the number of days they work in the month. Of course, no, you should not count manually but should use a function. It is difficult to count manually when there are many employees or they work half a day. You use the following function to count the number of working days of each employee in a month. Every time you mark a working day, the function automatically counts the total number of working days in the month for you. So at the end of the month, you just need to look at the total number to know the number of working days of each employee. If you don't want to see ugly zeros, then change the font color to white. I have basically completed the job of tracking and calculating the number of working days for each employee in January 2024. I recommend that you enter some data to check if the spreadsheet is working properly before going to the next steps. Next, I duplicate the sheet for the following months of the year. The number of days in February can change in different years, so you use the function to determine the number of days in this month. For example, in 2024, February will have 29 days, but in 2025, February will only have 28 days. In any year that is divisible by 4, February of that year has 29 days. In the remaining years, the number of days in February is 28 days. Because I duplicated the sheet, the formatting, functions, and everything else were kept the same. After completing February, you create new months for the remaining months of the year. Except for February, the remaining months of the year all have a fixed number of days in different years. I trust you will complete the remaining months of the year just like I did. Above is how to create a spreadsheet to track and calculate the number of working days of employees in a month. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck.